So I've come over to the Isle of Man at the invitation of the Isle of Man Medical Society to speak to the doctors on the island. This has been a long-standing engagement. So it's taken us a time to get here, but it corresponds, obviously, with discussions about Rosalind Ranson's tribunal case. That has become very disturbing to us in the VMA because of the wider implications beyond just the Isle of Man about doctors raising concerns and whistleblowing in generally. I met with the doctors of the island last night, and what was really alarming was the description of the culture of fear that they work under. So I had 60 doctors in the room, and it was a universal comment that they live in fear of raising concerns, that bullying seems to be endemic. And then when we look at Dr. Ranson's case, it is incredibly, incredibly disappointing that a doctor who is extremely competent, doing their job, trying to save lives during the COVID pandemic, was not only ignored and prevented from raising her concerns with government, but then is vilified for doing so. And that is not only completely unacceptable, but it really asks questions about how your health and social care system is run and what the interaction is between the people who run that system and your politicians. So what's important from our point of view is that we need to support the doctors on the island to be able to speak up safely. It's clear that Dr. Ranson's case is one of what seems to be many whistleblowing cases that have been over the years on the Isle of Man. And you know, here was a doctor desperately trying to save lives in an uncertain situation at the start of the pandemic, using the evidence that was available to her to lock down, provide care. And you know, it is shocking that people died unnecessarily because of her being ignored, and that then continued to lead to destruction of her career, and that just is unacceptable. But what's more unacceptable is the suspicion that this is systemic. This is wider spread, not just within the Isle of Man, but it reaches out into the UK. And so, you know, I've really got to think about how to approach this with UK government. I'll be asking to see the health secretary about both the Isle of Man and the implications for England. And then there's the Minister for Crown Dependencies as well. This is really concerning, and the Isle of Man people should be really interested in having the wrongdoing here exposed.
Would you agree that the source of this is political and bureaucratic control overwhelming medical professional judgment, and that interaction is at the core of the problem that we're seeing roll out and has rolled out?
Well, there is no doubt that professional judgment was suppressed and overruled. At what level that happened, it's difficult to say. You won't know unless you have a public inquiry. And that inquiry probably needs to be organised from off the island, because you know, independent inquiries are not always as independent as they would seem, and you need to have a genuine exploration as to exactly what happened during the COVID pandemic. But also you need to open up how to make sure ensure that this doesn't happen, and how to stop this from being an ongoing situation? Because at the moment, I have seen really very little evidence that this couldn't happen again.
In the absence of actually having a current public inquiry, are you intending to request Kate Bronner KC's public review, COVID review, extending, because she has the power to do so, extending certain elements of her work into being declared as a public inquiry?
Well, what we've agreed between BMA UK and the local medical society is that we will stay involved to keep oversight of whether progress is being made. Now, it may be appropriate that that can be done within the COVID inquiry, and I know there's a lot of confidence in the KC that's been appointed. But this is much wider than just that kind of inquiry, and you know, you need to have a real public look at the wrongdoing that's been going on for many years and continues to happen today.
Thank you.
Just as quickly, you said about continuing to support on the island. With Dr. Ranson's case, she was able to have legal advice through her family, and also she's shown quite a lot of tenacity and bravery to continue it with herself. Can you offer a guarantee to other doctors on the island that the BMA will stand by them from the get-go if concerns are raised and they do find themselves in a tribunal situation with Manxcare or DHSC?
Well, what you need to be is in a position whereby you don't get to a tribunal stage, and that's why we're going to get involved very early on. I've started my interaction with Manxcare today to raise concerns now. What the difficulty is, you know, Dr. Ranson was extremely brave. By being brave and standing up for something that was right and just, she's lost her career. I sat in a room of doctors yesterday where they would not put their heads or hands up because of that fear. Now, that has to stop, and that's what the BMA will be getting involved with.
It's 10 years ago since the previous minister was, I think, pretty good, had to stand down because it was all these consultants at the hospital, red flagging everything. 10 years ago, were you as a group then involved, or is this something very recently you made aware of what is going on here? Because it's literally been going on for a long, long time.
So I think there's been a number of issues. The BMA is looking to support whistleblowing cases much more, and whistleblowing cases legislation is quite difficult traditionally to prove. And what we're trying to do is to get to a situation where the concerns are raised and tackled by the BMA before it becomes whistleblowing. And that's not just the Isle of Man. There are a number of trusts in England for whom similar concerns have been raised, including some trusts where there have been high suicide rates amongst doctors. And the BMA really is giving notice that we are going to support our doctors in changing the culture, because there is a cultural failing here within these organisations. These organisations and setups have been toxic organisations, quite possibly still are. You need proper scrutiny and governance, and there's a clear lack of that from what I've seen over this last 48 hours.
The West Midlands Health Authority were having a look at us time to time in the previous administration. Would they have not picked up on all these sort of things as well then? Would they not be talked to and discussed?
Well, what I think has been clear from my visit is a disconnect between who runs the health service and what is actually going on the shop floor. it's a system that doesn't really want to know what's wrong with it. It only wants to know what's right, and therefore you are hearing the wrong messages. I've had two taxi journeys while I've been on the island, and I've learnt more from the taxi drivers about what's wrong. They nailed it both times. The word bullying came up in both conversations.
I'll hang on for a friend's one.
At the commencement of Mike's care on the Isle of Man, I made the point of expressing real concern about the mandate that the Manx Care work under, and it's deficient in certain areas. Is it possible that the BMA would want to look at that mandate and as a union offer their commentary about it? Because it is flawed, and I believe it's part of the disconnect that you've just raised there.
Well, I think our role as BMA UK is to support the local BMA members in being able to look at how healthcare is provided, how to get a more open and transparent system, how to make it fit for purpose, and how to make it so that the clinicians and patients drive the service rather than management and politicians. Because, you know, there is a definite disconnect there. There's definitely not a joined up thinking about how to provide care in the safest manner. Clinicians are reporting being ignored repeatedly when they raise concerns. So we are going to be supporting the local negotiating committee, the local medical society, to organise and become effective in standing up for doctors